Let's talk about some of the things you can't see, Max, like the engineering, because clearly it's got the DNA of the Double R, but people often ask why the engine is tuned differently to a bike like the Double R. So can you please explain this to us? Because it's a question that does come up a lot.
Absolutely. So I know there's been a lot of talk about the so-called new hypernakeds, and everybody needs to have 200 horsepowers now and then. To be frank, we could have given you 200 hp even back in 2014 when the first model came out, because we had the power in the Double R. But we decided on purpose to build a designated roadster engine. Why we did so is pretty easy. If you know, horsepower is basically just torque multiplied by the revs. So in order to obtain higher numbers on paper in horsepower terms, you just push the torque range into the higher rev range. This is not something you probably want on the street, because we all know from old 600cc days, people would just need to ring out into very high revs to get the power. What you want to have on a roadster coming out of tight corners, you want to have more torque down below. So you try to focus on the mid rev range with the old bike and end up with more torque where you actually ride. So then the new Double R with the shift cam try to combine these two old engines, try to combine that mid-range torque from the R engine with the top end from the old Double R. And it was very successful in doing so. But still, you would need to retain all the other aspects in the engine, like the exhaust cam profiles, for example, or the header diameters, and optimize all that for that maximum rev range of 14,500 rpm, because you need to retain those sticker HPs on top. So if you just focus purely on the mid-range and say cap the revs at 12,000, it allows you to optimize everything around the combustion chamber, like the intake, like the exhaust manifold diameters, like the cam profiles for that mid-range. And you end up with a bike that's both for you guys more affordable to buy and more fun to ride on the street, because you got the torque where you need it and don't need to pay for stuff you will not even use on the street. I mean, it's nice. We're all grown ups and just, I mean, we become bigger, but we just mentally stay kids. And it's, of course, cool to show off with some 200, 208 horsepowers. But I don't get it. What is the point of having 200 horsepowers if you need a supercharger and end up with a bike that is heavier than a full-blown S1000XR touring bike? What is the point of having 208 horsepower on paper, but they're only made available in fifth and sixth gear at speeds beyond 220 kilometers an hour? I mean, I want to ride twisties. I want to have fun on mountain roads. If I want to go fast in a straight line, I use a train. So I think it would be better if we, as a industry in general, try to focus less on just marketing numbers and trying to build bikes that are better to ride. For example, the weight reduction. We focused a lot on the weight reduction because this is where you actually gain your performance. We've also seen that performance figures from the old S1000R against the modern hypernaked community wasn't really behind it. So what you feel in braking, what you feel in steering and agility is weight, it's not the horsepower. So overall, I think we as an industry should, and I think we will, I've heard some rumors about other bikes also trying to reduce the weight. I saw some Italian brand yesterday also featuring carbon fiber wheels to reduce rotational mass. So I think we as an industry are slowly getting the message where it's really what counts on the street.